In this lesson, we will see how we can create and publish a report in Power BI. For that, we'll be using Power BI service. So the report will be published from your Power BI desktop to Power BI service. Let's see. Create a report and publish it to the Power BI service. We'll publish report from the desktop to service. This is what I said. Okay. Previously we saw what is a report. A report can have multiple pages. Consider that the first page will have the summary of the report. Okay. We will also see how we can publish and export a report in different formats. Let's see. First we'll open Power BI. Go to start. Type Power BI. Click open. Now let us open one of our previous projects. We can click open here, or we can directly go here and click our file amit_power_bi. Click on it. Now we opened it. So here we were having multiple pages. Okay. You can check. Got chart, column chart, cards. So let us publish this only. Okay. So first what I'll do, I'll create a new page by clicking here and I'll type, let's say lessons or summary. Okay. And I'll drag it here on the first one. Now let us write the summary. I'll click here first and go to format your report page, and here I'll click page information. Name is fine. You can allow a tooltip also. Canvas settings, click on it. Type is fine. Vertical alignment, fine. Background. Let me add the following background. Transparency. Okay. We can make it a lighter one also again. Let's say the following. Okay. I'll add a text box here. Now I'll add a text here. My Supermart report. I'll select and let's say 40. This looks fine. Or my store report. Okay, I can click and take it to the center. This looks fine. Now I can add the sections also. I'll take a text box. Okay, now let us add the topics. Okay, first let us increase the font. 32. I'll write got chart. Then we created a column chart, cards, tables, filters and slicers. Okay, we can also add the background here. Click here, go here, properties you can change, position also, title you can also set, effects. Let's say the background color. I'll now change it to the following. Okay. You can change the transparency from here. Okay. Now that's it. Now we have added a basic summary. You can also change the background color here. So let's say I'll just click and go to effects and change the background color. Okay, fine. Now I'll select this. Herein I'll select font color white. Now this looks fine. Okay. So generally we have these pages in our report. So reports basically have a grid like structure wherein generally you can add 12 different sections. since we created these projects before, so I'll be directly showing you how a report will look when we'll publish it. So I am here. You can now directly click publish to publish it. Now, do you want to save your changes? Save. Now it will ask your email address. I'll be adding my work email address. Continue. You don't seem to have an account. Okay, to sign up for an account, click here. I'll click here, let's say. Now it will take us to the sign up under Microsoft Fabric. What kind of email is this? I got it from my organization. Okay, click next. Now create your account. You can add your number. Text, I'll first select India. I'll first select my country, then the phone number. This is only for verification. It's written, click send verification code. So we got the code. I'll type it. Okay, now go below. Here and you can click verify. Now create your password. Also, it will send a verification code to your email ID. So let me check my email ID. Add the code, verification code. That's it. And we have created the password also. If you want, you can click here. Click next. Okay, you need to also add your name and everything else. Country India. Business phone number. That's it. Now go below and I'll select this also. Click next. Now this is your username. Your email ID is your username. Click get started. Now it will open your Power BI service. Now here it is. Now here you can see the workspace is visible. I'll click and here is my workspace. You can create a new workspace here. I just clicked on it and click got it. Okay, now I'll go to my Power BI. Click continue. Now click publish and it will ask you to enter the same email ID. Click continue. Enter the same email ID and password. Click sign in. Click OK. Click done. Now you can see we have logged in. So you can select a destination for this report. You can directly click my workspace because we were having this workspace. We can also create a workspace later on. So consider workspace as a place, as a folder, which will include your reports. You can also create a new folder within your workspace. So I'll just keep the default. And I'll click this and click select. Now it is publishing from Power BI to Power BI service. Success. You can directly open it from here. Now your Microsoft Fabric will open your report. Here it is. We created a report and we published a report from here. Okay, that is from our Power BI desktop to Power BI service after login. Now you can also see here, let's say I'll go to slicers and you can see the report is interactive online also. Let's say I'll just click on accessories to get sum of profits by state according to, let's say, accessories category. You can see it is interactive. I'll just remove them and you can see it is interactive. Okay, so your exact report is here. Okay, you can also edit it from here directly. Okay, so guys, we saw that whatever we published from our Power BI desktop to service is interactive in a similar way. Okay, you can also check here. Okay, like this. Now I'll click on export. I'll directly click on PDF, let's say. Export with current values and click export. Now let's see what will happen. It will open. It will export to PDF. Now PDF is visible. Here it is. Okay, you can click here and find it here. Click on it to open. And here is your PDF. Okay, we just created a demo and it has shown us the first page summary. Second was Gauss chart. The third was your column chart, and in this way we created it. Okay, and the last one was the following in a PDF format. Okay, so in this way you can also export it in PowerPoint. Okay, here is the notification. You can check. We just created our PDF file. This is your My Workspaces and it will include your current one. You can also create workspaces here by clicking here and selecting new workspace here. So here, click got it. Here we can also add some stuff. Let's say we added this here, My Store Report, and we can also add a text box here like Gauss chart or slicers. Okay, similarly, in a similar way by clicking text box and it will get added here. Okay, it will show you because we already signed in. Let me click here, Power BI service, and it will open the same. Okay, and below you have your workspace, the first one which you created under My Workspace, Amit _ Power BI project. Okay, so in this way, guys, we saw how to create a report, then we published it. We worked on the free version only. And then we also saw how we can export. And we also saw how we can go from Power BI desktop to Power BI service. We also exported a report in PDF using the free version only. Thank you for watching the video.